track. And we had an office task. Was that under staff work that the task procedure would be followed and staff had one in? Had that school part of the service that the board would require. And if they were, wasn't this evidence to our staff? And if they weren't to work, is this a training position?
Joe?
Joe, that's my opinion, I have the question, but I just wonder if you put alarms in with a more perspective, it's clear in terms of, you know, being the strategic director responsible for this particular area, which might bring into play if we're working to that. I think that thinking, answer to the councillor Williamson's question, absolutely right, but did it look authentic? Yes, it did. Having said that, we had a process in place and we simply didn't follow it. And if we had done, as authentic or not, we wouldn't be in the position that we are in that position now, and we are feeling, you know, the consequences of that. It was fraud, but nevertheless, we actually committed the error in terms of processing that payment. But we have had long-standing processes in place to make sure that that doesn't happen. And the voting processes have been followed when time and life would be in the position we are now. Those processes have been reissued to staff so everybody knows again what to do in similar circumstances should they happen. But it's important to note that in terms of whether it's error, negligence or anything else, that I have authorised that appropriate internal disciplinary investigation does take place. I don't want to prejudice the outcome of that, I just wanted to reassure members that they are taking it seriously.
Thanks for that, Joe. I think the concern with this is that it's not a member to members, so the board is more compared to the state. That's what we're saying, and that's where I can go back to John's question. Is there a training issue, which obviously Mark clearly to address? Because obviously, one person's making a mistake, it's understandable. Well, it's acceptable, but it's understandable for two people to make the same mistake compared. Mistake of the magnitude that it is. But if, you know, all of you could have been 400 million pounds, you know, it could have been any figure, which that to be £47,000, but it could have been any figure through that particular person. Fraud, you know, it's the fraud, not the figure, is the important point. But I think the most important thing is there was more than one person to count the mistake. And that does look to us either it's a training issue. It's not following proper procedures, and that is a bigger concern, and that's your training issue.
Yeah, just to clarify, just in terms of that internal discipline investigation, just put on more and more person.
Any more questions?
Yeah, I mean, you know, mistakes will happen. This looks like a very sophisticated fraud, and one can understand how it came about. I think the concern for a lot of members was how it was reported in the public domain, and it made it look as though we maybe knew about it but didn't inform a hierarchy of people to know that the incident had taken place. Now, apart from stopping fraud happening and more robust and, you know, things being in place, we have to make sure that when something does go wrong, we don't compound that state by looking stupid or looking as though we're denying or doing, you know, things to hide it, hoping we've never seen the light of day. This thing has seen the light of day and didn't see it in the best way. It was reported in the press that it was reported because of an FOI. That's how the press reports were. That's true enough. I'm concerned that in these circumstances, if something like this happened, and what seems to have happened is it scrubbed it very quickly, it happened very rapidly. What things in the process to start happening again and so on. So we reacted quite responsibly. We discovered it, because often these things can go undiscovered. We discovered it and we've done something about it, but what it actually turned into then was another PR disaster in terms of, and you know, I have to say, people who were asked about it in the press, I think the three party leaders may have been quoted, I'm not 100% certain. They seem surprised that this happened. Now, if it happens, there must be a way. this, so I want to, you know, don't need the answer to that, but I want to know that if this was to happen again or something similar, who and when in so would the strategic director get told within a day, within 24 hours, would the leader or the three party leaders or the spokespersons or whatever, who gets informed? Because, again, quite clearly, but again, this is about public perception. We are, you know, trying to be on the journey of improvement, but these are sort of things that make people say, oh, you know, say no. And I'm actually just, you know, there's the technical issues and the financial issues and regulations and making, you know, rules and regs. But again, it's how we deal with it. And, you know, so, you know, we could have made this more responsive if people were in the information. Process, and I just hope that a piece of work can go on about that sort of process as well as simply saying, you know, we've got a month, we won't get a month again, we need to get the PR right as well.
Can I just go back one thing? I think it's very important, not talk about, don't talk about now, so we might tick a wrong box or something else. There are several errors that can be made. But when do we see these, what the final step is? It's very hard to see that failure to do it for now. It could be a failure that hadn't been told because they had to do that in the first place. And that's a failure. But it needs two people involved in that. But that, to be told, you've then got to contact the supplier and security professional. So that's not taking the box. You either do that or you don't. And if that is your last safeguard against the fraud, which could have been part of it, then that to me doesn't come to an end.
I mean, that goes to the chair. We have a reassurance that investigation, that process will take place. We have to accept that. My view is that we are, you know, we have this public money that sort of has, and people out there want an assurance that we're doing everything possible quickly and it openly as well. I think it's the way we want to move forward. And we did. For whatever reason, the press may want to report it whatever way they want, but the reality is it wasn't happening the best way. I want to, you know, want to make sure that sometimes this happens, it will happen in organizations, that the right people know that the logical provision is. I'm not saying it's all about image because the 45,000 may be covered, may not. It's about being, you know, compounding mistake of some sort, compounding. Maybe in social, maybe in the title of that book. But by compounding it by looking stupid in the press, it doesn't help anybody in the organization.
Actually, just a quick response to the council apart from some valid points there. So, I think, first of all, the pleasing thing is that we did discover it. I mean, it used to be made and alerted. Internal alerts and that prompted an alert to the police. We were asked to not publish any further information about it. Well, they were to computer investigation. That information, unfortunately, was subsequently published on our website, to which we then had to respond publicly to do that. Prior to that, we were doing what the investigation team had asked us to do, which was to keep it quiet. That said, in terms of broadening who could have known and who should have known at that time, I think there's something for us to learn about that. We certainly take that on board, and we have put in a different process to allow that to happen. But we also have to accept. Sometimes it's keeping the lid on things is not always within our own jurisdiction in terms of
that. We mustn't forget to have a sophisticated fraud. The email came in, wasn't the graphic Nigeria was the outcome discussed. It did contain within it that was to a previous remit of vice. We have the different effects of better headings and learn and so on. It looked legitimate. However, at the end of the day, we still have a very elaborate top secret procedure in place that wasn't supposed to be employed. There's no way around that. That's the bottom line. We've already certainly it went as far as directors, directors work for a teacher did that, that next step up to directors. And there were reasons why that wasn't the case, and Joe's a bit particularly fact that we were advised by the police like to not sort of do any of the things off the investigation of one person. So we were trying to limit, I think we as in the organisation was trying to limit the number of people that were aware of and being exposed to this. For good reasons, but at the end of the day, it should escalate as far as it's pre-directed and it's complete. It should not be in a situation where the wrong bank will be able to get the hospital issue. All the actions that are included in the National Plan, I have to agree with my that there's a real sort of desire to ensure that we get this right so that we don't want to have a game. I think I've covered all the issues. Like, regards to the police interest, and their involvement with the particular case, like, it has been a bit of an ordeal to get them interested in this, I'll be fairly honest with you. There was very little activity from day one. I think, had we not been feeding them information, which I described, related to the council, they may or may not have detailed the hospital sequence. We are sort of thankful we have a sort of inquisitive investigator on the team and then was very keen to sort of try and see if we get the hospital to go and to get to the hospital and so on. It's certainly worthy of consideration sort of raising this with sort of city officers from the force. Looking into that now, we can actually. Have I missed anything? I recognise the colour everybody's question.
Certificate, which might also refer to before, we have all that one. So, we're two items outstanding. One is to hold the company
not a standard recommendation to be dealt with. In terms of quickly clicking through the highlights on the item 6, both the annual building statement has been completed, that was completed in September. The annual building statement will basically include the accounting recorded. So the number of actions has gone down. Things like inversion for the payroll controls from the external report, the external audit report. Instead of the external audit report, the issue there around the attention of documentation, controls and everything will be placed to sort that one out. And then further, there's one around the email around journals, the records there, that's a simple one. It's not record attention. Not with the errors in the journal, it's just the records that are attention. So that's been in place to sort that one. What we're recommending to do there is bring this report back on a regular basis to show that the recommendations are being implemented. So we'll look at you by the packages sort of have been resolved before we get to the completion of 2013-14. The other item that comes out again is audit letter, sort of includes the process about 12-13. And we'll be now publishing the back and all this has been included in the application of the best. In terms of what happens here, but
I just wanted to on page 57, the notification of completion of the work. Other than that, there's still a bit of a similar to the detail in our actual report.
In terms of the two items, the one that holds the character of the issue is we really have to be specifically 5 minutes in September. Thank you.
Side, but also